All right. Dividing polynomials. Thank you for driving math with Mr. Glenn. Or tune it in to driving math with Mr. Glenn. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to break this down to be able to divide it. So we're going to say 40e squared over 5 minus 25e over 5 plus 10 over 5. Okay? Makes it a little easier for us. So we got 40 divided by 5, which is 8, and then e squared. Got that one. 25 divided by 5 minus 5e, and then plus 10 over 5 is 2. There's your answer. So all I did was just kind of break it down into fractions that are dividing by the greatest common factor, basically. So this is 9x to the third divided by 3x plus 30x squared divided by 3x. 3x divided by 3x. So 9 divided by 3 is 3. X squared, I'm sorry, x to the third divided by x is x to the second, because 3 minus 1 is 2. 30 divided by 3 is 10. X squared divided by x is x. And then 3x divided by 3x is 1. And that's how you divide a trinomial by a monomial. Now here comes the little bit of a challenge where we have to divide a monomial, divide a trinomial by a binomial. So let's see what we got. You say, okay, polynomials, why do we need to know those? Well, you never know. Math is problem solving. So if you can solve problems, you can solve math problems, you can solve problems in life a little easier. Okay, so also polynomials in the grand scheme, they're used to, in one way, they're used to build roller coasters. Right? I'm not saying you're going to be building a roller coaster. I'm just saying that's just one way to, that's just one thing that polynomials are used for. So, all right, so we're going to use the concept of long division to solve this problem. All right, but the first thing we're going to do is look at the first terms. How many times does x go into 3x squared? So we would have to do 3x squared divided by x. It gives us 3x. This 3x is going to go where the like term of three of the variable is. All right, so then we're going to take that same 3x, the same 3x, and we're going to multiply it times x minus 5. What do we get? We get 3x squared minus 15x. And we're going to write it here. 3x squared minus 15x. Now remember, we're subtracting both of these. All right, so we're going to 3x squared minus 3x squared. That's 0, right? That cancels out. Negative 19x minus negative 15, that gives us negative 4x minus 20, right? We're gonna bring that down. So now we go back to the start over. How many x's go into negative 4x? Negative 4x divided by x gives you negative 4. Negative 4. We're going to multiply negative 4 times x minus 5. What do you get? Negative 4x plus 20. Okay? So we're going to get, make sure, so you have negative 4x should be Did I write that number wrong? Yeah, I did. No wonder. Should have been plus 5. So before, that should have been plus 15. It's a positive 4. Okay, positive 4. Should have been 19x. Positive. Oh, wow, I didn't see that well at all. All right, so go back. So we got plus. All right. So then we subtract even 19x minus 15x, which is 4x. Got you. And then this would have been plus. So it's, see what happened if you write the information wrong? So this particular number is not negative 4x. It's positive 4x, which gives you 4. So it's a plus 4. So that's 4 times x. Yeah, okay, so it's 4 times x is 4x. 4 times 5 is 20. So it's positive 20. We're going to subtract. That gives you 0. Here's your answer. And to check it, you can do FOIL or you can do the box model. Yep, you got 3x squared plus 4x plus 15x plus 20. Combine like terms. Alright, went a little fast. But you can always slow that down, okay? And that's how you solve dividing polynomials. Let's try this one. So let me write it down. Okay, so notice that it's not in descending order of the power. So it's a 16c to the third. Same process. We start with the first two terms. So we're going to see how many times 16, how many times 2c can go into, 2c goes into 16c to the third. So 16 divided by 2 is 8. C to the third divided by c, c to the second. So we got 8c to the second. We're going to take a c to the second. We're going to multiply that. Gonna multiply that by 2c minus 5. We get 16c to the third minus 40c to the second. 8 times negative 5 is negative 40c squared. So we take that information and write it here. I remember learning this too. This was kind of complicated for me as well. Gonna subtract, so we distribute that, okay? And the signs are changing. This becomes positive 2c squared minus 11c. Okay, how many times can 2c go into 2c squared? That's 1, and that's c. So that's a positive c, 1c. And I'm just erasing that so it doesn't look like I'm saying that it equals that. So that's 2c squared minus 5c. So 2c squared minus 5c. We're simply changing each sign. Now we have 6c, drop down positive 19. 6c divided by 2c gives us 3. All right, 3 times 2c minus 5 gives us 6c minus 15. 6c minus 15. We subtract. Make sure I got that right. Yeah. Should be. Should have been negative 3. So negative 3, positive 15. So we end up with negative 6c plus 15. Change the signs. That's 4. And our remainder, so it's plus 4 over 2c. 2c minus 5. And that's your answer. So now sometimes there may be a part of it missing. So in the sense of here you have x to the third plus 125 divided by x plus 5. All right, so we're missing x to the second and x. So we're gonna have to write that in. So x to the third plus 0x to the second plus 0x plus 125. And then we have to solve just like we've done before. X to the third divided by x and gives you x squared. All right, so this is x squared. So once you plug these zeros in, so placeholders, and then you just solve it as we did in the previous part or the previous lesson. So x squared times x plus 5 is x to the third plus 5x squared. So x to the third plus 5x squared. We're going to subtract. So that's negative 5x squared plus 0x. So we have negative 5x divided by x gives you negative 5. So negative 5 goes here because because it cancels out. Yeah, because this is negative 5x squared. So then we're going to go negative 5 times x plus 5. That gives you negative 5x minus 25. Oh, that's what I missed, because there's not a 2 there. It's like, man, you can't, what am I doing? Gotta, that's little bitty parts mess you up. So negative 5 and then x. So negative 5x. And the reason why I knew that I had messed up is because I couldn't just go to this particular part of the quotient if I hadn't solved for this part of the quotient. Negative 5x times x plus 5. As you can see, I'm making a lot of mistakes, not intentionally, but just to kind of show you, it does take some time to kind of get this down. And so don't be too bothered at yourself if you don't have it. Okay, just keep practicing. And you'll find a particular rhythm that shows you what you're doing wrong. Like, you'll be able to see, oh, okay, that doesn't make sense, because you'll see the pattern. So 25x divided by x. And then, from the, you thought that was challenging. All right, our last problem is a little more challenging than that one, in my estimation. All right, so 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, 2, 0. As you can see, we're missing the 1 exponent, so we have to put it there. And then divide. The T's, I don't know why they give us that, because it seems like they look like pluses, you know? So here we go. T to the fourth divided by T squared is T squared. So we're already there, T squared. So we multiply T squared plus 0T plus 2. Okay? That's T to the fourth. 1 times 0 is 0. And T to the second times T. T to the third, T times 2, it's 2T to the second. So we have T to the fourth plus 0T to the third plus 2T to the second. We're going to subtract. So we end up with 3T to the third plus 4t to the second plus 11t. Let's do the same thing. 3t to the third divided by t squared. That gives you 3. And then t. So that's plus 3t. And then we're going to multiply 3t times t squared plus 0 t plus 2. So we end up with 3t to the third plus 0 t to the second plus 6t. So 3t to the third plus 0 t to the second plus 6t. And then we're going to subtract that. That cancels out. 4t squared. And that's minus 5t plus 5. So we have, then we got 4t divided by t squared. So it gives, it's going to give us 4. So it's plus 4. We're going to do 4 times t squared 0 t plus 2. Right? And that's 4t squared plus t 0 plus plus 0 t plus 8. So we end up 4t squared plus 0t plus 8. Basically, we're distributing that negative. So we end up with negative 5t minus 3. Man, that was exhausting for me too. So I do apologize for how long it was. If you see anything that was incorrect or you didn't understand, put it in the comment section. And I'm willing to change it and go back over it and review it with you. Thank you for tuning in with Mr. Glenn while driving math and helping you get to your destination of understanding math and math concepts. Share, like, I already told you to comment and subscribe, as well as hit the notification button. It's a lot of things to remember. I get it. I'm cool if you just choose one of them. Thank you for your time. Good day, mate. I'm not Australian, but I'm just saying good day. Have a good one. Bye.